So this is going to be a double review. Here, first I'll do Barricade. So he's got a pretty nice looking car mode. Wait, that's a little close. Decepticon stab, Decepticon stab, ramming grill. This window was broken off, but it actually looked kind of better. Anyways, so solid car mode, that's why I got it, but the robot mode isn't that pretty. In fact, it's pretty damn simple, but it has one nice feature. Anyways, Barricade died in the first movie, I remember. I'm pretty sure he did, but he came back in the fifth movie for no good reason, other than he looks cool, and yeah, he didn't do jack all in that fifth movie. Okay, so right now we got Barricade transformed. Obviously, this is pretty damn ugly looking. He's not one of the new, wait a minute, this arm is jammed. There we go. His arm always gives problems. He doesn't look that great. I think it's because this is one of the cheaper toys, but he's about the same size as Ironhide. And he has one cool feature. He doesn't have any guns on him, and his arms don't bend, but you push this plunger on the back, and he's got a buzzsaw. Wait a minute. Which is pretty damn cool. So you can have him cutting through another enemy, that sort of thing. But since he looks so ugly in robot mode, leave him in car mode, which looks way better. So yeah, I think Barricade would have been a really cool character, you know, if they let him develop instead of letting all the human type characters get all the lines in that movie. Let's see. This always pops off, but it goes back on pretty nicely, which it really gets rid of some of the worries of that weakness there for that ball joint. But yeah, I'm pretty sure he was a Stunticon. Not sure which part he was. Anyways, that's the end of Barricade. So I'll leave him here. He has a cool car mode. And this is Ironhide. So Ironhide goes pretty well with Barricade, stepping on him. And he has the same type of weapon thing. Push it, spins, and this one locks if you pull it back. Which is cool if you want it to look longer, like a Megatron cannon. Yeah, I like that spinning gimmick. Anyways, let's push Barricade off the side for a second. Ironhide, let's see. Ironhide in the movie, I'd say he's pretty good. He's basically a redneck. Pop that down. So you got his cannon on his arm or in his hand. I'm not sure which I like better. I think I like it better on his arm, but yeah, that's what it sort of looks like. So let's start transforming him. He's got this automorph gimmick, is what they call it. So basically, when you transform it, push it one way, it starts moving the rest of the parts. You can sort of see it. It's hard to do. Wait, let me do this fist. All right. Yeah, so you can hardly see that going, but it is going. It works better on some other figures if you take a look at them when they automorph. So, yeah. GMC. Hope that's close enough. Pop that down. Ironhide was also one of my favorite characters from the G1 cartoon. They made him... basically, he's a go-get. He'd go after any Decepticons in his path. He gives a good advice to Prime, and yeah, in IDW comics, or one of those comics, they basically say his armor is laser-proof, that's why he's been around so long. But he's a solid warrior in the comics, and yeah, I really like him. So this is a little bit difficult. Wait a minute. I think it would have been easier just to transform that Automorph from last. That's Automorph from last. Whatever he did. Let's do the back end first. So his armor panels go around his legs, just like Bumblebee does. Armor panels do. So he has a weird. He looks really weird when he's transformed. You'll see it. I'll point it out. Let's see. He would be a really neat truck, but he is missing parts on him. I'll fill that in later. But let's see. I thought there was a bottom half here. So this is what his bumper looks like. I think it says Road Armor at the bottom. I guess that's a brand deal they had or something. I guess that's nicer. Whatever. Anyways, I'm having trouble with his legs here. I'm not sure why I'm having so much trouble with his legs. There we go. So you see the back of his bumper? It pops out from the bottom of his feet. So the tailgate has Autobot symbol on it. I'll show once I click these things two together. And the reason he will look so weird is parts of his panels are missing. I mean, I could fill that in later with other pieces of plastic, but you know that he won't look that great in truck mode. Yeah, so he's missing his windows and this little section here behind the doors. And the back here is supposed to look like this, which is ugly. It should have a flat piece detached. I'll just make another piece later. But yeah, so obviously his truck mode's the weakest right now. But so we could have his cannon pop on his the top of his hood, but the roof, but I really don't like the way it looks. I mean, that looks weird for a truck. So I'm gonna transform it back to well, here side by side, that's what they look like. Right now it looks totally awful except for the front view. I'll fix that later. So let's leave him in robot mode because he obviously looks way better in robot mode than vehicle mode. So yeah, this transformation is not the hardest, but it takes some time to get used to. Well, not used to, just figure out. So let's work out the legs. Wow, that's stuck in there. I'm just talking. There we go. That was a little bit harder than usual to pop out for a normal Transformers figure. I like this one because it doesn't have a lot of sharp bits like some of the other Michael Bay movie figures. It feels like you're gonna slice your damn hand when you're trying to transform them. So here, wait, oops. Well, good thing this is on a slidey hinge. That's what I'm calling them. So that just slides back on. I'll do it when he transforms. It's hard to do it right now. These are some pretty tight tolerances on these things. So I like that his bumpers come out and become sort of his arm pads. I mean, shoulder pads, elbow pads, whatever. I'd say forearm pads. So yeah, let's pop these down a little. So his automorph looks a little bit like this. So he looks like a midget right now. Wait, let me fix the legs first. So I think this is supposed to be like an engine block defense thing. So automorph is... I'm gonna pat it too close. I'm not doing this twice, but yeah, like this. And then you push it back. See? Straight, right, one finger, push back. It looks okay, kind of okay, but I'd rather just normal morph it. I mean, it might be useful for something else in the future. Pictures of him have his grill on the outside of the GMC. I like it on the inside because it just looks weird. Pop this back in. So you turn his tires sideways to fill in the gaps. And then just pop this on his arm, just forearm, just to see. Leave it for that way for now. And that's what he looks like. I think Iron Knight could have used a battle mask, like some of the other figures, but he doesn't have one. So, yeah, that's Ironhide and Barricade.